Can I be free from thoughts while interacting with the world? Can I be free from thoughts when I am interacting with the world? Is what you call a Jivan Mukta. Okay. So the yogis try to achieve, to become free from thought. Yogis try to do lot of breathing practice, pranayama, bandha. They are suppress the thought. Okay. You understand? They are trying to force the thought. Forced to reduce the thought, yogis. But can I be simply, gently, naturally be free from thoughts? Okay? Right? Can I be easily be free from thoughts? That is the Jnana Marga. And that's called Sahaja Marga, or a natural way I can be free from thoughts. Why? Interact in the world also. Okay.
Then, if you see Brahman in the world, then
it happens. If you see Brahman in the world, it'll happen. Right? So, how do you see Brahman in the world?
Reminding all the time that he is all pervading, inside, outside, is there.
What is inside and outside for Brahman?
Inside me and inside.
Inside me means who?
That this body, mind, intellect is all because of him only it's functioning.
So?
And everything outside is also because of
something
him.
Is inside and outside is there for Brahman?
No.
No, not for Brahman.
Okay.
I as a Jivatma.
So, I as Jivatma should disappear. Then there is nothing called inside outside. Yeah. Right? Interesting. So, I as Jivatma, then you say inside me and outside me. Okay? That means as if Brahman is cut into two. Inside and outside. That means the clarity of Brahman is still not there.
That is, I am in Brahman. And for that only we need these classes to keep us reminded.
So, this inside and outside, the moment you say inside and outside, already Brahman is two pieces. Okay? So, all that is there is Brahman only. Okay? For that, we have to understand, we'll go through one prakriya called Satya Mithya Jnana Prakriya. Understand what is Satya, what is Mithya, okay? So, get a clarity. Can you switch on the light, the two dots? Yellow dot is ready. Switch on. Okay. Correct. So, we have to understand what is Satya and what is Mithya. And today I will teach you a process by which you can attain Sahaja Samadhi or remain in natural state with the understanding of Satya and Mithya. So, what do you understand by Satya and Mithya? See, these are Sanskrit words, okay? We are more comfortable with English. What is sound coming? There's an ocean in the background, okay? So, here, can anybody tell me what is Satya and Mithya in English words?
Truth and false.
Truth and?
Untruth.
Okay. So Satya is called truth or reality. Okay. Mithya is not false. Okay. Mithya is unreal. I cannot say it's real. But I cannot say it's false also.
It's not permanent.
Mithya is unreal. Okay. So just started. Today we are conducting a prakriya or a process called Satya Mithya Jnana. What is Satya and what is Mithya as you understand? What is the word for Satya?
Satya is a truth, which is a reality. But when we say reality, most of the time we say what we see, perceive, but reality is beyond that.
Okay. So, mithya means? Mithya means appearance, which is not real, right? Satya means real. Mithya means not false, unreal. Okay, there's a distinction between this real, unreal, and false. So this is the basic understanding we have to get clearly for understanding Vedanta. Okay, so there's a cat there. That's real, but it appears like a lion, which is a perception. Okay, so if you understand the satya mithya clearly, practically you understood Vedanta, depth of Vedanta. Okay, so there is something called perception and reality. Okay. Perception and reality, the perception is called mithya. So if you want to use a word English called, perception is mithya, reality is satya. Okay? Perception is mithya and reality is satya. But always we live with the illusion in life that perception is a reality. That's called maya. Perception is reality, is our understanding of life. Perception is never real. Okay? Perception is unreal. That's called mithya. Reality is called satya. Okay? So without reality, is there a perception possible? Is it possible to perceive something without a reality there? So reality is always in the background of perception. Okay? Without reality, there's no perception possible. Reality is required to have a perception. Right? A screen is required to project a movie. Without screen, the movie cannot be projected. Like that, reality is always in the background of perception. Is it clear? So let me take some examples. I see water in a desert. Okay? The water in the desert is actually called mirage. Mirage is perception but not real. What is real there? Sand. Reality is sand. Perception is water. Are you clear? Reality is sand. Perception is water. So, the mithya is water, satya is sand in the desert. But the mithya is experiential reality. you can see that there is a water. Okay? You can see that there is a water, right? Either it's available to experience senses, many times perception is available to touch, smell. So, experientially real, but factually unreal, is called mithya. Experientially real and factually unreal. Okay? So, this is definition of mithya is experientially real, factually unreal. It's called mithya. Is the definition of mithya clear?
Guruji, what's the difference between perception and mithya?
Perception is mithya.
Perception is mithya.
All perceptions are mithya. Okay?
Unreal and perception.
Unreal is mithya, perception is mithya. Okay? But it's called unreal because experientially it's available. Right? Experientially there's water there. Experientially, I can see water. Oh, I can experience. Then people say, no, seeing is believing. Actually, seeing is believing, but it's not real. Are you clear? Experiential reality is called mithya. But not factually real, factually correct. Pratibha, we are trying to understand what is satya, mithya, and she can tell, her name itself is like that. Satya means real. Mithya means unreal. Okay? Now satya is reality. Mithya is perception. Perception is called mithya. In English word for you is perception. Perception is not real. But perception requires reality. You can, without reality you can't perceive something. Right? So at desert you see water, you call it as water. The water is mithya, the desert is satya. But without desert there is no mithya possible. Clear? Okay. Is this much clear at all?
Experientially would mean through the sense organs.
Our experience can only come through five sense organs. Right? So it's available to five sense organs. One of the five or all the five. Eyes, I can see it. Ears, I can hear it. Taste, I can touch it. Taste it, touch. So these five sense organs give experientially real reality. Okay? And all experiences are perceptions. They are not reality. Is this clear? Perception, reality, is, difference is clear to all? So, another example. Earlier days, people thought there's a rabbit in moon. Okay? So, because the shape of the landscape on the moon appeared like a rabbit. They say there's a big rabbit on the moon. There's no rabbit in the moon. There's a perception. Okay? The reality is there's a landscape there. So, perception and reality difference you have to understand. Is it clear? Now, reality is there, perception is there, that's called satya and mithya. So now, let us take a case of a rabbit with a horn. Is rabbit with a horn is real, satya or mithya?
Neither.
It is neither satya nor mithya. It is unreal, don't exist, that doesn't exist. It's called asatya. It's called false. Okay? So there are three categories: satya, mithya, and asatya. Okay? Asatya means never existing. A horn of a rabbit is not existing at all. Okay? The children of a woman, barren woman, don't exist. They're all category of asatya. So this class is not about asatya. This class is only about satya and mithya. Okay? Asatya we are not interested because it doesn't bother us. Right? So but in Vedanta when they talk something, they use the word asatya for mithya many times. Okay? Asatoma sadgamaya when they say, asat there represents mithya, not asatya. So the word over a period of time, asat and satya, mithya word have got interchanged in the Vedanta. But we should be clear, mithya means unreal, satya means real. Okay. So in the Vedanta, this example given for this is called a roe and a snake. Okay. Are you able to see?
It's okay.
No.
It's
You can sit here. Huh? Yeah, you can sit here. Sit here.
Yeah,
no problem.
But
as long as you are able to see. Yeah. So in Vedanta, the typical example given is a rope and a snake. Now, can we apply the satya mithya to snake and rope? Somebody is going in the night and he sees a snake. Now, the snake is a perception, but he doesn't know it's perception. Okay? Is there experience now? What is the experience?
Fear.
There's fear, there's heartbeat, okay, there's a snake-like appearance, correct? But there's no snake, it's a perception. In Ajnana, perception is reality. Okay, so he sees a real snake there, in ignorance. Is it clear? That's mithya, mithya. I have told you, mithya means experiential reality. Okay? But that's, it's not there, absolutely real. Factually it's not there, but experientially it's there. Experientially there is a snake. But is there really snake? There's no snake. Is this clear? Okay? So, we should not confuse the experiential reality with the factual reality. So when Brahma world is, I say, Maya, how can the world be Maya? I am experiencing it. Right? I am experiencing it. The first objection you raise is, I am experiencing the world. How can it be Maya? It's Maya because you are experiencing it. Are you clear? So first thing we'll deny, say that the world I am able to experience it. How can you say it is Maya? That is the real, that is the very definition of Maya. We experientially there, but factually not there. Are you clear? This fundamental mistake, even after many years of Vedanta Jnana, people say, no, I am understood Vedanta, world is Maya, but I can't experience it. The very fact that you are experiencing it is Maya. Are you getting logical contradiction what you are having? So, Ramani, you understood? I am not able to experience the world as Maya. The world, very world which you are saying, I am experiencing world. How can it be Maya? That itself is pointing that it is Maya. Experiential is something is there, it is not real. But experiencing is useful. I'm not saying no. Experiencing is useful. Right? Experiential reality is useful, but not truth. Absolutely not truth. Is this much clear? Okay. So this confusion of experience and truth. That's why in Vedanta, all spiritual experience, I say, okay, you had a good spiritual experience, wonderful. Now find out the truth. So, I had a wonderful spiritual experience. What is the wonderful experience? God came in from me. Very good. Now find the truth. Because all experiences are in the domain of Maya.
So is if you are out of Maya, the experience is stopped.
Come we'll on. Find out now.
I mean the experience through the sense organs is also gone.
We will find out. This class is about finding out. I am not giving you answers. Okay, so this very clear to you, because many of the people in Vedanta, they say, I understood Vedanta. What is Vedanta? Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya. Okay, world is Maya. I understood. But I am not able to experience it. There itself you are stuck. Okay, the Maya means experientially real, but factually unreal. Okay?
There is a truth behind it.
That's fact. The fact is that. Truth is
there.
Okay. Is this much clear? Okay. So, now the question she has raised is, what is the question you said? Perception will disappear.
If you are out of Maya, all your experiences will stop.
if you are out of Maya, all your experiences are stopped. So somebody can, how many, let's say vote, how many people believe that if you are out of Maya, all experience will stop? How many people vote for that? She says, if you are out of Maya, all experience will stop.
I think you would stop using the senses. Stop using the senses.
All your senses are shut down, okay? It's not that, right? So if you are in a mirage, and you understand it's a mirage, mirage need not stop. You can then walk on the water also.
The understanding.
Then should mirage disappear?
It will be there, but you know it.
Yeah, you are not bothered. You know I can walk on the. You don't. You know that I can drink water on that, but I can walk on the mirage.
Yeah.
Right. See, this is the exact meaning of many of the spiritual miracles which are said in literature. He walked on the water, okay? People think it's a factually correct information. It is not. The water is always samsara. Samsara is maya. So he walked on the water means he is not affected by that. So then people convert into miracle. Oh, that man is a great man. He walked on the water, he said. So what happens in spiritual or the mythological literature, the truth gets converted into myth. Myth gets converted into? Okay. So he walked on water. What a great man he is. Okay. The water in Vedanta, or water in spiritual terms, represents samsara, moving. Okay. It is not real. So people, normally all the people in what you call so-called samsaris, they sink in water. Because they think it is real. Whereas this guy, he knows it unreal and he walks on water. Okay, otherwise, without knowing this, people convert this into a big miracle. Oh my God, that guy is a great sage, he walked on water. Okay.
So when you are out of Maya, you experience everything, but you are not affected by it.
Absolutely. Okay. That is called Sahaja Samadhi.
Then why are you saying this? Because you are in Maya, you are experiencing. That's why, that was your earlier statement.
No. Maya is when you are experiencing, when you are believing your perceptions, it's called Maya. I said, perceptions are not real. If you believe perceptions are real, then you are in Maya. Perceptions are not real. No perception is real. Why it's not real, we'll find out. Okay? But if you start believing perceptions as real, you are in Maya. Okay?
Sir, here, perception of a snake by seeing the rope in the darkness is unreal. But the perception of rope itself is...
Perception of rope itself is?
Rope is also a perception.
No, it's a rope is a perception, but it's only given as example. Okay? It's only given as example. Because your example, Atma is not available to perception. So it's only given example to relate to. Okay? We'll find out what is that. Is this much clear to all? So, here, the corollary is, perception is unreal. Okay? Believing perception is real is called avidya, ignorance. Okay? This was clear? Avidya means I start believing in perception. Vidya means I believe in perception is perception. Okay? So mithya is experiential reality but not factual reality. One example of that, you know, in dream. Okay? In dream, you went to a beautiful place. So there is a flower there, you can smell it, you can touch it, you can pluck the flower. there are tigers, animals, everything is real, right? Experientially, it is real. All sense organs are operating fully. Is it clear? So is dream experiential real? Everybody agrees? In dream, tiger comes, you'll run. In dream, you fall from a mountain, you'll break your leg. Experiential reality is there. Okay? But you only say it's not factually real. Why? Yeah, it's all dream here. Yeah. Why you'll say that?
You woke up from the dream.
You wake up from the dream. How do you say there's no tiger there? It's not real?
Actually, it has not happened.
Huh?
It has not happened.
Oh, it happened actually. You went
in
to.
In the dream.
In the dream, it happened, no? In the dream, it happened. But after waking up, it's not there. So, after waking up, from waking up point of view, you say dream was unreal.
The person who dreams is all not real.
It's also not real.
So that's why the unreal man is dreaming unreal.
Correct. But that you will say only after waking up. While experiencing dream, the tiger comes, you'll run away. And wife comes, you sit quietly. You'll say, no, this is a dream wife. No, you'll say. Yes or no? Experience of dream is real when it's happening. The perception is real when it's happening. Okay. But when you only come out of the perception, it appears unreal. Are we clear? So right now you are experiencing this class, you are sitting here. Is it perception or reality? Is it perception or reality? Is it mithya or satya?
Mithya.
Then why did you come all the way from your house?
To wake up.